Premature infants weighing as little as a pound are hooked to ventilators, monitors, and other machines inside incubators so their lungs and other organs can more fully develop. Children's Hospital of Philadelphia, known as CHOP, is aiming for a gentler solution.
The challenging age that we're trying to offset is that 23 to 24 week baby who is faced with such a challenge of adapting to life outside of the uterus on dry land, breathing air, when they're not supposed to be there yet.
CHOP researchers are testing a device that would give those preemies a couple of extra weeks in an artificial womb.
It's meant in some ways to swaddle and keep the fetus supported physically the way that it would be in the uterus.
The technology was tested on fetal lambs whose development is similar to humans. A bag is filled with lab-made amniotic fluid. The fetus inhales and exhales the liquid as it normally would in the womb, and the heart pumps blood through the umbilical cord into a kind of artificial lung outside the bag.
It is a fluidic incubator, so the infant is re-immersed in an artificial amniotic fluid, and the infant will survive inside the biobag with the oxygenator on the outside for a period of up to 3 to 4 weeks.
The 8 fetal lambs that were tested in the device seem to develop as they normally would in the womb, some even growing a little wool. Researchers hope one day the same technology could work for human babies.
With each week of advancing gestation, the morbidity and the mortality progressively decrease.
The researchers say they're not aiming to extend viability earlier than the current mark of 23 weeks. The goal is to help extreme preemies develop more normally with fewer health issues. Human testing is still 3 to 5 years away, although the CHOP team is already in discussions with the FDA. Dr. Max Gomez, CBS 2 News.